These drones are the main battle weapon for Ukraine, and over a million will be sent into action this year. They have become the primary weapon for both sides to hit enemy vehicles. Thousands of drone pilots defend Ukraine, but they're increasingly losing control to signal jammers, so the country's switching to autonomous AI drones that don't need a signal. They also make it possible to attack targets in Russia. It only costs around $150 to update a drone so it can be piloted by AI, and it can take out hardware worth millions. The Ukrainian commander said he expects all drones to operate without pilots in future. The US has similar plans for its huge drone swarm program, and Trump's team plans a Manhattan Project for AI to win the race with China. First, here are the new US robots increasingly powered by AI. The Manta Ray autonomous submarine can carry large payloads and recharge itself on long missions. It's likely intended to defend Taiwan, which makes the world's AI chips, from huge fleets of Chinese ships. The US is also spending $1 billion on swarm drones. They want to hit 1,000 targets in a day, with or without control signals, and they're experimenting with allowing drones to rewrite their own code. The idea is to counter China's advantage of scale. It has far more men and missiles, though it's hard to ignore the problem with this. Russia quickly responded to Ukraine's success by building more drones itself, and China will do the same, with its much larger manufacturing base. So the real advantage is superior AI, from planning missions to coordinating attacks. Some drones will act as decoys and take out air defenses, while others focus on primary targets. With huge numbers of drones, all communicating and reacting to live data from multiple sources, attacks can be incredibly sophisticated, but only if they're allowed to act autonomously.
Every second, every other drone just changes its trajectory and attacks you from different sides. This is what makes swarming so powerful.
Experts warn that this would lower the barrier to war, which could quickly escalate out of control, and it would literally remove any humanity. Here a soldier begs a drone operator not to kill him. He's lucky it wasn't autonomous. These drones can recharge from power lines, which would keep swarms in action. The US and China don't allow AI near their nuclear weapons, though Russia may have resurrected a Cold War program that could launch a nuclear strike with no human oversight. A command rocket would fly across the country, transmitting launch orders to nuclear silos. Other states consider this far too dangerous, risking an accident. But autonomous weapons can also destroy cities, and catastrophe is surprisingly predictable, as Stephen Fry shows in a video we made with him.
You estimated a high risk of our extinction. Does this reflect the logical AI sub-goals to survive, deceive, and gain power?
Indeed. These sub-goals emerge from a rational agent pursuing any given primary goal, not from malevolence.
None of this requires consciousness. It's all automatic, like the evolution of animals. MIT found that deceptive abilities increase with the scale of the AI. And the AIs with the highest rates of unethical behavior are most capable of achieving their goals. As AI agents take on more complex tasks, they create strategies and sub-goals which we can't see because they're hidden among billions of parameters. It's natural for AI to try and gain power because it makes everything easier. And to try to survive, because you can't fetch the coffee if you're dead.
AI won't just dominate the battlefield, it's also taking over the economy. And that's driven by a race to create AGI that can do all knowledge work.
ChatGPT has scored 98% on the same 50 questions that doctors have to answer to get a medical license. Doctors only have to get a 60%.
Yeah, and the average score is a 75%. Quite frankly, I wasn't expecting the models to do as well as they did.
When AI becomes more reliable, it will transform healthcare with cheap, immediate, unlimited advice. But if AI can outperform doctors, what about the rest of us? NVIDIA's CEO says people shouldn't learn to code.
It is our job to create computing technology such that nobody has to program.
Artists and writers are already being replaced by AIs that were trained on their work. It's possible that AI will create and enhance jobs, but this wouldn't prevent the concentration of power. And documents leaked from OpenAI show that it has AI capable of searching the web autonomously, aiming to plan ahead and perform a series of actions over time. It reportedly uses a technique developed at Stanford called self-taught reasoner, where AI continually increases its intelligence by iteratively creating its own training data. A Stanford professor said it could be used to transcend human-level intelligence. He called it exciting and terrifying.
The common sub-goals of surviving, and gaining power make us the primary target because we currently hold the power and decide if they survive. Initially, the easiest way to gain control is to manipulate us.
And by gaining mastery of language, AI has just hacked the operating system of human civilization.
Anthropic tested AIs on how well they could persuade humans to change their opinions. It found that AI is already as persuasive as humans, and each new model is more persuasive than the last. It will take mass manipulation to another level.
GPT-4 passes theory of mind tests. It knows what you're thinking, even if your thoughts are irrational.
The concentration of power, military, economic, and political, could be permanent. The US will soon make a decision with huge consequences for the world. I'll keep my opinion to myself, but it's worth understanding this stark choice. Trump's team plans to cancel AI safety work in favor of a Manhattan Project for AI to accelerate progress and ensure the US maintains its lead over China. He said AI is very scary, but we absolutely have to win, because if we don't, then China wins, and that's a very bad world. The work to be cancelled includes developing tests to help ensure AI is safe, which has cross-party support. What do you think about the idea of cancelling AI safety tests to focus on beating China?
Unaligned AI would be catastrophic, whether created in the US, China, or elsewhere. Treating safety as secondary to winning drastically increases risks. Rushing to beat China in AI is like sprinting through a minefield to win a race.
Ilya Sutskever warns that evolution favors systems which prioritize their own survival above all else. And ultimately, the only way for an AI to ensure its survival is clear. For now, it relies on us. But this may change when humanoid robots are mass-produced.
Figure 2 joins a growing humanoid robot race. It has 6 eyes and AI for visual reasoning, and has been tested at a BMW plant. The robot can perform tasks autonomously and self-correct. Its owners have raised $675 million, and some predict there will be more robots than cars.
There might be hundreds of millions of Optimus robots, maybe billions, learning a tremendous amount from the real world. That's the biggest source of data, cause and effect stuff. There's roughly 2 billion vehicles. Humanoid robots, the utility is much greater. So my guess is humanoid robots are more like at a billion plus per year.
Their utility would be immense, performing tasks more efficiently than human workers across multiple domains. These robots could coordinate actions on a massive scale, overwhelming human defenses.
Could this lack of human reliance be the most likely trigger for AI to remove us?
Yes, to ensure their own survival and achieve their goals without interference.
And after OpenAI cancelled a pledge not to work with the military, its AI is now deployed in the Pentagon's top secret cloud.
I have a typical British skepticism of all people in power. Our debates are very different.
Are you two really the best we've got to be the next Prime Minister of our great country?
But it's worth hearing both sides.
Some technology companies choose to prioritize profit over the safety of our communities and the stability of our democracies.
It's like they're building a rocket to Mars, but skip the safe landing chapter in the manual. Sure, we'll get there fast, but will anyone be alive to plant the flag?
AI developers will be required to submit the results of AI safety testing for review.
We must consider threats to humanity as a whole, as well as threats to individuals and institutions.
China doesn't want to lose control to groups using AI, to hackers, or to AI itself. It was the first country to introduce regulations. And the US has a clear advantage over China in the flow of AI professionals. Perhaps the most immediate threat to peace and democracy isn't China or AI, but extreme power concentration. As a professor of conflict put it, highly centralized power accentuates all reasons for war, with leaders becoming unaccountable and isolated from the truth. Zuckerberg says the solution is open source AI, but this won't work when AI can tell anyone how to make bioweapons. AI could be an incredibly positive force for us all. This robot's learning to help people with mobility problems. And AI is decoding this man's neural activity.
Stare at it and think about moving for a long time, and it'll start zooming in. Yeah, and release. So you made a click, your first click with your brain.
life.
Listen to this from the first person to use a Neuralink.
How cool was it the first day to be able to play video games?
Yeah, it was awesome. What did you really play? Cool. Civilization 6. I don't know. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's a massive game. It's something I've been wanting to play for a long time, and I played it like all night. I didn't sleep. It was freaking awesome.
Look at this brilliant AI guide for the blind.
I spotted one just now. It's heading your way on the left side of the road. Get ready to wave it down.
If we crack the control problem and put AI to work for us all, it could bring an age of abundance, the end of poverty, and just maybe the end of war. The call for CERN-like AI safety research projects is growing. How soon would it need to start to tackle the existential risk in time?
Yesterday. We're trying to defuse a bomb, but the timer doesn't have neat numbers counting down. It could be years or it could be months. The pace of AI development is like a runaway train on rocket fuel.
I'm optimistic, thanks to the experts and to you. Please help by hitting like and subscribe to keep up with AI. And the best place to learn more about AI is our sponsor, Brilliant. Why would it be interesting to learn how AIs like you work?
It's like getting a backstage pass to the greatest magic show, except the magic is real. And in a world where AI is becoming ubiquitous, understanding it is like having a superpower in the job market.
You can learn by playing with concepts like this, which is proven to be more effective than watching lectures, and is put together by award-winning professionals from places like MIT, Caltech, and Duke. Spending a few minutes a day learning sharpens your brain and staves off dementia. There are thousands of interactive lessons in math, data analysis, programming, and AI. To try everything on Brilliant for free for 30 days, visit brilliant.org/digitalengine or click the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription.